This is Pantera Electronics. Today we're going to take a look at the ignition switch controller. We're going to have installation here. I'm going to tell you about the features. This is the controller itself. It gets installed behind the switch console, and it's a single board. The cable and the harnessing plugs directly into the Pantera cable harness without modifications. You remove the connector that resides over the steering column and you put on quick disconnect terminals and connect it to the board. You also need to add a push button switch. In this installation, we've installed it in place of the dimmer control for the dash light, since it's typically not turned down, and this push button fits directly into the hole. This controller offloads the high currents from the ignition switch and also provides a push button start, a true push button start that once the engine started, the button is disabled, can't crash the starter gears. We also maintain exact functionality of the ignition switch by turning off the accessories when the push button start button is pressed to engage the starter. Most aftermarket push button starts do not deactivate the accessories, which offloads the accessory load during starter engagement, provides more current for the starter motor. So let's take a look at this. There's going to be indicators on the board and I'll explain what they do. First we'll turn on to the accessories. If you notice, a yellow LED comes on to tell us that the accessories has been turned on and this is powered up. And the next position on the ignition switch is run. And that has a green LED that's illuminated to show us that that's powered up. Now we see that the push button is flashing, indicates the engine is ready for starting. And we can press the button as many times as we like to start the engine. We don't have to turn the key on and off again, which is a big advantage in a Pantera. I'm going to purposely not allow the engine to start. You can still see it's flashing, it's telling us it's still ready. Once the engine started, the flashing stops. Purposely let it stall, so that it shows us that it's re-enabled by flashing. We'll start it again. As long as the engine's running, you can push it as many times as you want. It does not crash the starter. Now, to shut the engine off, in this design, you have to turn the key back off. And there's reasons for that. One thing about this is also unique is it doesn't disable the use of the key for starting the engine. And if you'll notice, the accessory LED will turn off. So this push button start allows both the push button and the key to operate it. And it doesn't matter. It's a very easy installation. Very simple, you just make an additional small harness and it can be tucked away behind the kick panel. I've left it open so you can see that the board is not very large. The push button switches come in three colors from Pantera Electronics, blue as this one is, red and green rings. Thanks for stopping in. Take a look at our other products and you'll see we have a nice line.